Of God teaching me who the Holy Spirit was. Because I realized I had heard that before. But I didn't look at it or follow it or internalize. That particular day I decided, why don't I try this voice? And I came out and I called my daughter and I said, tell those boys outside, I used to keep chicken. I said, tell the boys outside, thieves are coming to our house tonight. They think you are not, what is it? What, mommy? Tell them thieves are coming to our house tonight. And you know what happened? I was preparing myself to go for a fellowship at AIC in Kongoro. It was a Wednesday meeting. I prepared, and as I was going out, the boys asked me, "Mommy, what did you say?" I told them, "Thieves are coming to our house tonight." I didn't add anything. And I left. So we do what? I don't know. So the boys. So we do what?
So the boys went and tried
to put electricity all
around.
They put everywhere. And I went and I came back. When my husband came. And of course he's here, he sits down, so he doesn't understand some of these things. So he told them, he was told. Mom said thieves are coming here tonight.
Mama alisema ya kwamba wezi wanakuja usiku wa leo huku kwetu.
She said that. Well, I'll take care.
Akasema alisema hivyo, basi nitashughulika.
He doesn't want to tell them that is, I don't understand, but he said, well, I'll take care.
Hakuweza kuambia haelewi, lakini anasema atashughulika.
They took care. And at night,
na usiku,
we ate, we had dinner, and we stayed. About 11, I went to bed.
Tukakula saa 5 hivi nikaenda kulala.
My husband knows.
Mwangu anajua.
When I see something, there is something about it.
Nitakaposema jambo kuna
jambo. He may not tell them, but he knows. So he left. He did not go to sleep.
Angewapia lakini angeenda kulala.
He sat at the sitting room.
Akaketi asebuleni.
Around 1.
Kama saa 7 hivi.
Around 1 o'clock.
Saa 7 usiku.
We had the missus, because the boy said, "You stay 1 hour, you sleep and come."
Vijana walikuwa wamesema wewe unalala saa moja alafu mimi nakuja.
The first boy saw people coming.
Kijana mmoja akaona watu wanakuja. Wakiwa na
the small house behind, and they are trying to remove the bulbs.
Wakapita nyuma ya nyumba na walikuwa wanajaribu kutoa zile nyaya za stima.
Then they continued.
Na wakaendelea.
But when they reached here,
na walipofika mahali,
they had scissors to cut the wires to go in.
Walikuwa na makasi ya kukata
mawire. When they tried to cut,
walipofika ukawa na
moto. And the boys say, "Who sold and said thieves?"
Na vijana wakaanza kupiga firimbi wakasema kuna wezi.
I told my husband.
Nikamwambia mume wangu,
"There are your people."
Sasa ndio hao watu wako.
And by that time they had cut a very big place.
Na wakati walikuwa wamekata mahali pa.
What am I trying to tell you? When you walk in the spirit of the living God,
wakati unapotembea ndani ya Roho Mtakatifu,
God will show things before they come.
Mungu atakuonyesha mambo kabla.
But you must be sensitive and conscious.
Lakini lazima uwe.
It doesn't just come.
Haikuji tu.
And the Holy Spirit doesn't force, he comes as we invite him.
Na Roho Mtakatifu ajiradhinishi anakuja tunapomkaribisha.
And I know.
Na ninajua.
This afternoon.
There
is something very special.
Kuna kitu cha
Mungu. Shall we put our hands together as we welcome Mr. Kawati to this microphone, together with our interpreter, Apostle Brian, in the name of Jesus.
Praise Jesus. I want you to think about
the King of Kings, about the Lord of Lords, about the one who was stripped naked for you, about the one who gave you the power, authority, dominion, about your great high priest who's seated at the right hand of the Father, about the one who did not just give you power, but he gave you the power to be called a son of God. You know, if you don't know somebody's worth, you will underpraise them. If you do not know about somebody's worth, you will underworship them. To the perfection that the Father had in mind when he was sending his son. He was not thinking less of you. He was trying to make more Jesuses on
earth.
That is why you have the same name, child of God, son of God, a priest. He is the high priest, and we are priests.
Amen.
Amen. Do you get it?
Yes.
At least a little bit. Okay, now with that wisdom or with that knowledge, can you now appreciate him for who he is? He is the Son of God. He is the Prince of Peace. He is the healer. He is the assurer. He is the deliverer. The Gadarene man
Ule mjamani wetu ni very man.
He was just hungry.
Alikuwa tu na njaa yeye.
And there was a person selling githeri.
Na kulikuwa na mtu anauza githeri.
Inakajiwala.
Eh, ndani ya karatasi.
And he was just in the line to vote.
Na yeye alikuwa anaenda kutoka kupiga kura.
Just, you know, kurugarugia, you know, githeri.
Ile githeri ya kurusha rusha.
You know? And there was somebody.
Na kulikuwa na mtu
who thought it was funny.
Ambaye alifikiria kwamba hiyo ni
at the right time.
Kwa wakati unaofaa.
Took the right picture.
Akachukua picha
hiyo. It went to the right place.
Ikaenda mahali panapofaa.
And the very man.
Na yule githeri man.
When he woke up that morning.
Alipoamka asubuhi.
At the time he was going to bed.
Wakati alikuwa analala.
His life was turned around.
Maisha yake yalikuwa yamebadilika.
He did not pay anybody.
Yeye hakuwa na sababu.
He did not call a photographer.
Hakufanya kuja.
He did not pay for advertisement.
Hakulipa
hiyo. Ikaenda
lakini wakati unafika
favor, let me tell you,
kibali wacha nikwambie,
it is not fair.
Yes.
Hakitoshanishi.
Yeah.
Favor,
kibali
is not fair. Yeah.
Kitoshanishi.
Amen. God,
Mungu
is not fair. Yeah.
Yeah.
He is not fair.
Hatoshanishi.
If you disagree, can you show me in the scripture where it says God is fair?
Kama ukubali buni nionyeshe kwa maandiko bali nasema yeye anatushanisha.
God is just.
Mungu ni mwenye haki.
God is just.
Mwenye haki.
He's a just God.
Yeye ni Mungu mwenye haki.
Not a fair God.
Yes,
you are. So when you see me blessed,
unaponiona
nimebarikiwa, when you see me happy,
unaponiona
nimefurahi, unaponiona
nimefurahi,
when you look at the Kenyan man,
unapoangalia
Kenyan man, it was not fair.
Si haikuwa na
chini. But he got it.
Lakini alipata.
Now today.
Sasa leo.
Today.
Leo.
Today.
Leo.
You know what I tell God?
Unajua mimi niambia Mungu.
I cannot if I children, you know, I used to be there 10 years of Nyayo era, those little kids that were dancing and playing, it was me.
Ya wale watoto wa miaka 10 ya Nyayo.
We were saying 10 and then years. Oh,
unasema miaka 10 ya Nyayo.
We got the milk. We went into the night green buses.
Tulikuwa wasiwa tulienda kwa mabasi.
He was just like this. He stands up and dances with us.
Na anasimama anacheza na sisi.
And he reaches out to his pocket and he
anafika kwa mfuko
anachomoa.
Anatoa soda.
Give his children.
Patia watoto soda.
Now if an earthly king,
kama huyo ni mfano wa duniani,
can do that.
Anaweza kufanya hivyo.
He is an earthly king.
Yeye ni mfano wa
duniani. And he is not even holy.
Na yeye si
mtakatifu. He is not even righteous.
Na yeye si mwenye haki.
If you evil men know how to give good gifts to your children,
na kama nyinyi watu wabaya,
then how much more will the heavenly Father,
na baba yenu wa
mbinguni, give the Holy Spirit,
akupigia
who is a perfect gift,
ambaye
ndio mtoto wa Yesu, kwa wale ambao to those who ask,
wale wanao
to those who ask,
wale
wanao to those who ask,
wale wanamtaji.
I am telling you today,
ninakwambia leo,
I am telling you today,
ninakwambia leo, na kwa kuuliza leo,
to ask,
ukauliza.
Take your seat in the presence of the
Lord. Keti chini katika uwepo wa Bwana.
Take your seat in the, we are seated in the high place.
Tunaketi katika mahali pa juu.
In the heavenly places.
Katika mahali pa
juu. With Christ Jesus.
Pamoja na Kristo Yesu.
I need 3 glasses here please.
Ninahitaji glasi tatu
hapa tafadhali.
Na ninahitaji maji.
See, I told you today I'll help you understand.
Nilikwambia leo nitakusaidia ukaelewa.
Eh, kosa. Facebook to see.
There are some people who are here on Sunday.
Kuna watu walikuwa Jumapili.
And those people will help me also preach because I'm going to catch you up.
Na hao watu watanisaidia kuhubiri kwa sababu nitawakamata.
I want 3 volunteers quickly.
Ninataka watu wa mama watatu wa kujitolea haraka.
1
Moja,
2,
2,
3,
3. Itosha.
You guys, you go back. Thank you very much. Come here. You are here. Come. When you're told to volunteer for something,
ukiambiwa ujitolee kitu,
what if I was going to give them some
meals? Na kama ningekuwa nikiwapea kitu,
you guys would have lost.
Ungeikosa.
Thank you very much for coming. May the Lord bless you.
Well,
and because you're here, you will get it. You know what you do, you retain it. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay.
So can you please fill this cup with water? And this one, just halfway. Yes. How many know who you are?
Wangapi wanajua wao ni nani?
What you were created to be.
Kile ambacho uliumbwa uwe.
Can you tell us who you are?
Hebu tuambie wewe ni nani?
I ask you, I'm meeting you for the first time, so who are you? Nakutana
mara ya kwanza na kuuliza wewe ni nani?
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
I didn't ask your names, I just asked who are you?
Niuliza wewe ni nani?
I am Beatrice Wanjiku. Beatrice Wanjiku. She said she is
Beatrice Wanjiku.
And I'm going to ask you the same question. Who are you?
Where are we now?
Pastor Faith Kemeu.
Is that it?
Metosha.
I'm saved and I'm a child of God.
Amen. Say amen.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
All right. When I asked you who you are,
nikikuuliza wewe ni nani?
She said she was Beatrice Wanjiku.
Alisema anaitwa Beatrice Wanjiku.
When I asked her who she was,
nilipomuuliza yeye ni nani,
she told me two things.
Aliniambia mambo mawili.
She said she's a pastor.
Yeye ni pastor.
Actually, not even two more. So I understood she's a pastor.
Kajua mimi ni yeye.
Secondly, she's somebody's child. She has a name.
Yeah, ako na jina.
Thirdly, she belongs to a spiritual entity.
Yeye ana ni wa kiroho.
A child of God.
Mwana wa Mungu.
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
What dictates who you are?
Ni nini kinatuambia wewe ni nani?
When Adam was created,
aliumbwa.
And Eve was created.
Na Eve akaumbwa.
There was something that God saw.
Kuna kitu ambacho Mungu alikiona.
And he said it is not good for man to be alone. So I'm going to create.
Sio vizuri mume awe peke yake, kwa hivyo nitaumba.
Ahu? Ahu? Did he say let us create Eve?
Alisema tutengeneze Eva.
Did he say I'll make Eve for Adam?
Alisema tutengeneza Eva kwa Adam.
What did he call her?
Alimuita nani?
What is a helper? What is the title? What does that tell you?
Msaidizi ni inamaanisha inaainisha nini?
Helper?
Msaidizi.
It is an assignment.
Ni kazi.
It is an assignment.
Ni kazi.
Say assignment.
Say assignment.
Say assignment.
Assignment.
All right. God, when he created, he said, let us make man in our own image and likeness that they may rule over the earth. What did he say?
Mungu alisema wacha tuume mwanadamu ili wakaweza kutawala nchi. Alisemaje?
What did he create man for? To get a name or an assignment?
Alimuumba mwanadamu kufanya nini, kupata jina ama kupata kazi?
So when I ask you who you are,
kwa hiyo nikikuuliza wewe nani,
you better tell me what your assignment is.
Afadhali uniambie kazi yako ni nini.
What is this?
Hii ni nini?
When I ask for a glass,
nikiulizia glass,
what do you think?
Wewe unafikiria nini?
You want to drink something.
You think about its assignment.
Unafikiria kuhusu kazi yake.
You know that she must want to drink something, that's why she's asking for a glass.
Utajua ya kwamba anaweza kuwa anataka kunywa kitu, lazima ndio maana anaitisha glasi.
What is this?
Hii ni nini?
What is this? If I asked you for a book, what comes into your mind?
Nini kinakuja kwenye kichwa chako?
I want to. Why? Because a book is for reading, right?
Kitabu cha kusoma.
We are very quick and very smart.
Sisi tunaharaka sana.
To create things.
Kuumba vitu.
Because from the need that we have.
Kutokana na mahitaji tulio nayo.
Somebody wanted to drink.
Mtu alitaka kunywa.
And realized they could not use a fork to drink.
Akajua hawezi kutumia uma kunywa.
So they created, they made a cup so that they can drink from it.
Wakatengeneza kikombe ndipo wanywe kutoka kwenye kikombe.
What do you think God is different?
Unafikiria kwa nini Mungu ni tofauti?
What do you think? You are just Evelyn or Rose or somebody's wife or somebody's mother. What is your assignment?
Kwa nini unafikiria wewe ni Rose ama Eva ama mke wa mtu ama mama wa mtu? Kwa nini unafikiri Mungu alikupa kwa sababu?
The reason why
sababu
we are defeated is because we do not know our assignment.
Kazi yetu.
This cup, a glass.
Glassy.
Lift it up.
Inue ju.
That glass is full.
Glassy le meja.
It's full of what?
Meja ni.
Lift it up. And that glass is
glassy
half full.
Ni nusu.
Right? And this one is. So, come in. The three of us want to give you a glass.
What are you going to do with a glass?
Which one will you pick?
Oh, nataka gani?
The full one. Good. Go back. Somebody else, quickly, quickly, quickly.
Grace, come.
We have three glasses here. Which one do you prefer? The full one. Good. Thank you, Grace. Hiya, Mrs. Come here. Very fast. Very fast. Very fast. The three of us have glasses. Pick one.
Okay.
Thank you very much. All right. Quicker. Human beings.
Hawa ni wanadamu.
And I am God.
Na mimi ni Mungu.
In action. I am a child of God. So, mimi you know, mtoto wa nyoka ni nyoka.
Yes.
Mtoto wa Mungu ni Mungu.
Child of snake is snake, child of God is God.
Right?
Yes.
It's true.
Yes.
It's a fact.
Yes. Yes.
I'm a child of God.
Mimi mwana Mungu.
So, I'm God.
Mimi ni Mungu.
And I want to feel myself in a human being. But I come to this one. And I can't. It's too full. Too full of themselves. Too full of the worries of this world. The one everybody wants to pick. I cannot fit in here. It is too full. The Holy Spirit goes back. Father. You sent me to them. They have no place for me. They are too full. Rivers of living waters cannot fit in a full vessel. They are not hungry. They are full. Father,
Baba,
the second vessel. It's only half full.
Mejanusu.
They only half empty. They only allow me to do what they want me to do. They don't want me to be God in their lives. They still want to be in control and tell me what to do. They will put me in a box. I will be useless in this vessel. I can add just a little bit of what I have. But I cannot give myself to the fullest because they don't have room for me.
Let's go back and do it a little bit. Let's go back and do
it a little bit. The Father,
Baba,
having given his son,
baada ya kutoa mwana wake,
because he missed the fellowship and the relationship he had with man.
Kwa sababu alikuwa anakosa ule uhusiano na ushirika aliyokuwa nao na mwanadamu.
Because man listened to the wrong voice.
Kwa sababu mwanadamu alisikiza sauti sio faa.
And became full of evil.
Na akawa amejawa na ubaya.
Full of the wisdom of the world.
Amejawa na hekima ya duniani.
That they cannot receive any more from God.
Ya kwamba hawezi kupokea zaidi kutoka.
They believe in death more than they believe in life.
Wanaamini kifo zaidi ya uhai.
They believe in sicknesses more than they believe in healing.
Wanaamini ugonjwa kuliko uponyaji.
If you tell them somebody was hit by a car out there.
Ukiwaambia mtu aligongwa na gari huko.
They have no problem believing it.
Hawana shida ya kuamini.
But if you tell them somebody was resurrected from the dead.
Lakini ukiambia kuna mtu alifufuliwa kutoka kwenye
kifo. They will say,
watasema kwenda huko.
Stop playing. What a joke. Because they have been programmed to receive from the world the wisdom of the world. The high priest did his work to perfection. He died. He suffered. He paid for it all. That you can have back the relationship that the Father so longs for. But you still are so programmed into the ways of the world, into the slavery of Egypt. We just went through the Red Sea, which is the blood of Jesus. But we stayed in the wilderness. Because you know what? Just because you're free by location doesn't make you free in your mind. They still had the slave mentality. They still were slaves. That changed location. Are you a slave in the kingdom of God? You are a slave when you are in the kingdom of darkness. A lot of people are still slaves in the kingdom of God. You just received a change of name, but not a change of character and mindset. You cannot be a without having the mind of Christ. And I will tell you that the mind of Christ does not come by osmosis. Does not come just because you said yes, no, come to my life. What the Lord has prepared for those who love him. But it has been revealed to us by his Spirit. It has been revealed to us by who? Only two people. From the people who left Egypt. Entered the promised land. Only two. That God the Father himself testified about. Not even their leader Moses entered the promised land. Did I tell you God is not fair? Did I tell you God is not fair? You think he's going to be a respecter of you because you're a pastor, because you're a bishop, because you have a title, really? You think that is what qualifies you as a child of God? Does that give you a mindset of Christ? If today I go to school and I become a doctor, I'm qualified to treat. I can treat patients, right?
Right?
So does that tell you that I'm immune to everything that I treat my patients,
they
cannot
do? You're immune
now.
You're
immune. Unless you're a child of God. And by the Spirit of God. Let me tell you. There is one thing that I need everybody to understand. Because some people choose who to believe and who not to believe. Some people say, I believe in God the Father. But I don't believe in the Son. We just spoke to a Muslim here who just said, you know, we respect Jesus. We call him Isa bin Maryam. But we don't believe that he was crucified. We believe somebody else went on the cross for him. I asked him who? He says, we don't know. I said, go ask that Father God that you believe in who went on the cross. Because you're so confused. You tell me he didn't, then show me who did.
Anachanganyikiwa sana. Kama unaniambia kuna mtu alifanya basi niambie nani.
He says I'm still going to school.
Akasema bado naenda shule.
I said they didn't know. They don't know. They're telling you it does they don't know who went to the cross. Ask God, he'll tell you.
Amuuliza Mungu atakwambia.
Some people believe in God the Father.
Kuna watu wanaamini Mungu Baba na Mungu Mwana.
And they stop there.
Na wanaacha pale.
And a lot of Christians do that.
Na Wakristo wengi wanaamini hivyo.
But you do not understand.
Lakini
you do not understand.
Hatuwele.
You do not understand.
Hatuwele.
There is a reason why Jesus said.
Kuna sababu Mungu Yesu alisema.
Hey, it is good, it is for your benefit that I leave.
Ya kwamba ni vyema ya kwamba mimi ninaenda.
Because if I don't go.
Kwa sababu nisipoenda.
You will not get the help that you need.
Hamutapata usaidizi.
You cannot know me.
Hamwezi kunijua mimi.
It is good that I go.
Ni vizuri niende.
Because when I go.
Kwa sababu nishikisha.
The Father.
Baba.
Will send you a helper.
Atawatumia
msaidizi. The Holy Spirit.
Roho Mtakatifu.
Who is the Father will send?
Yule ambaye Baba atamtuma.
In my name.
Katika jina langu.
For those who receive my name.
Wale wanaopokea jina langu.
And this helper.
Na huyu msaidizi.
Jesus did not say he will.
Yesu akusema
he didn't say that I am the one who's going to do this.
Hakusema sio mimi nitafanya.
He said the helper.
Alisema msaidizi.
Will teach you all things.
Atawafunza mambo
yote. And he will remind you.
Na atawakumbusha.
Of what I have taught you.
Ya yale niliyowafunza.
The helper.
Say this.
Say the helper.
Say this.
Say the helper.
Say this.
The helper.
Say this.
The helper.
Say this. Say this.
The kingdom of God is like a school.
Ufalme wa Mungu ni kama shule.
When you enroll in school,
wakati unaingia shule,
and you are accepted in class,
na unakubaliwa kwenye darasa,
and you do not go to the class,
na hauendi kwa darasa,
but you tell everybody you are in the university,
na unaambia kila mtu niko chuo kikuu,
you're telling everybody you are in the university,
unaambia kila mtu niko chuo kikuu,
I am enrolled,
mimi nimeingizwa,
I have paid my school fees,
nimelipa karo,
no no no, I have a scholarship,
mimi nimeflipiwa.
Let me tell you,
wacha nikwambie,
your father has paid,
Baba amelipa,
by the blood of the Son.
Kupitia kwa damu ya mwana.
But are you going to class?
Lakini wewe unaenda kwa darasa kweli?
Do you are you listening to your teacher?
Wewe unasikizaga mwalimu wako?
Have you entered the class?
Umeingia darasa?
Or are you just saying you're in school?
Ama unasema tu niko
shule. You will never graduate.
Hautawahi
fuzu.
Hautawahi.
You will come out the way you came in.
Utatoka vile uliingia. Hautafunzwa.
That is how many Christians.
Hivi ndio wa
Kristo. In the kingdom of God.
Ambao wamekaa.
And they are not. I don't have the mindset of God.
Hawana mafikra ya Kristo.
They have no power.
Hawana nguvu.
They only have a name.
Wako na majina.
Christian.
Wa Kristo.
Christian.
Wa Kristo.
Christian.
Wa Kristo.
Witches. Witches.
Mawachawi.
And witch doctors.
Na waroki.
Have no power.
Hawana nguvu.
Signs and wonders.
Wana.
They have more power.
Wana nguvu zaidi.
And signs and wonders.
Na ishara zaidi.
Than children of God.
Kuliko wana wa Mungu.
Because children of God.
Wana wa Mungu.
Have ignored the help.
Wamekataa usaidizi.
That the Father.
Ambao Baba.
And the Son.
Na Mwana.
Work so hard for.
Wamefanya kazi kubwa sana.
I want to ask you one thing.
Ningependa kuuliza swali moja.
How was Jesus conceived in Mary's womb?
Yesu alizaliwaje ndani ya tumbo la Maria?
The Holy Spirit.
Roho Mtakatifu.
When did Jesus start his ministry?
Yesu alianza huduma yake lini?
After baptism of who?
Baada ya ubatizo nani?
Did you have you read anywhere that he performed miracles, signs and wonders without the Holy Spirit?
Kuna mahali umesoma ati alifanyanga miujiza na ishara bila Roho Mtakatifu?
Now,
sasa,
do you understand why you are defeated?
Unaelewa kwa nini unashindwa?
Do you understand why you have sicknesses and diseases?
Unaelewa kwa nini unagonjeka?
Do you understand why you are not walking in full victory and as a son of God?
Kwa nini hautembei kwenye ushindi uliotimilika kama mwana wa Mungu?
You cannot ignore God.
Hauwezi kumwondokea Mungu.
And have the fullness of who?
Na ukapata utimilifu wa yeye aliye.
The Father said he created us in his image and likeness.
Baba alisema alituumba katika mfano na nena yake.
3 in 1.
Tatu ndani ya moja.
God the Father.
Baba.
God the Son.
Mwana.
God the Holy Spirit.
Na Roho Mtakatifu.
I have been created.
Mimi nimeumbwa.
As a spirit.
Kama roho.
Soul.
Kama nafsi.
And body.
Na kama mwili.
If my spirit leaves.
Kama roho yangu itaondoka.
How well will my soul and body do?
Nafsi yangu na mwili itafanya kazi namna gani?
Are Will I be able to operate? Without a soul, will I be able to operate? Without a body, will I be able to operate? And what makes you think you can pick and choose what redemption package to take? It is an all or nothing package. That is why the Bible says, because only those who enter the promised land are the ones with a different spirit. The spirit of God. Jesus said that they that are led by the spirit of God, they are the sons of God. I only reveal my secrets to the children of God. And the deep things and the secret things and the hidden things are only revealed to God's children by His Spirit. Because only the Spirit of God knows everything about God. If you want to know everything about me, ask my Spirit. It knows everything. When the Spirit of the living God comes into a believer who understands this, I will show you what happens. This sort of Christian, this believer is born again, came through the gate, but stood at the gate. That outside that gate. Outside that gate. If it rains, will the rain fall on you? Will the rain fall on you? If they smoke, will you smell the smoke? Right?
Yeah.
If there is fire and you're out there, won't it burn you? Right?
Where
are you sheltered out there? Is there food out there? Why are you standing out there? Who told you Christianity or being in the kingdom of God is entering through the gate and standing at the gate? Those Christians are called outer court Christians. Christians who dwell in the outer courts. When the sun shines, that's when they see. When darkness comes, they cannot see anything. It is darkness in their life. When the rain comes, they are drenched to the rain. When it is freezing cold, they are frozen. When it is too hot, they get sunburned. Why? He has a table prepared for his children. He's telling them, come in. The Holy Spirit, He's the one to lead you to me. But they're ignorant. And they have refused to be led of the Spirit of God. They're comfortable. They're the murmuring and complaining Christians. Thinking that the problem is God. But who is the problem? Who is the problem? If you look outside there, there is another tent. The second group of Christians. They have believed in God. At least they have come close. At least now they're studying the word of God. They are ready to be filled. But they are still full of themselves. They come into the inner courts. The light in the inner courts is not the light from the sun. It is the light from the word of God. If you read the scripture, the inner court had a lamp that had seven strands on
it.
And that lamp had the oil, which is the Holy Spirit of God, that keeps the light burning.
mafuta ambao ndio Roho Mtakatifu ambao ulifanya moto huo ukaendelea kuwaka.
And the Father said,
na baba akasema,
do not let the oil run dry.
Usiwache mafuta haya yakawahi kuisha.
Because if the oil runs dry,
kwa sababu mafuta haya,
you will not see.
Hautaona.
How many of us read the word of God without even asking the Holy Spirit, what do you mean? What does this mean?
Wangapi wetu tunasoma neno la Mungu bila hata kumuuliza Roho Mtakatifu unamaanisha nini? Hii inasemaje?
You just read the Bible with no revelation, no understanding. And let me tell you, the anointing is in the revelation. You are as anointed as your revelation.
Unasoma tu Biblia bila ufunuo, bila upako. Na wacha nikuambie, ufunuo na upako, upako unakuwa ndani ya ufunuo.
These Christians,
our Christ,
rely on the Holy Spirit.
Wanategemea Roho Mtakatifu.
But they still go back and forth.
Lakini wanarudi wakati.
But at least,
lakini
they have the word of God.
Wana neno kwa hali tu wana neno la Mungu.
There is a place where God wants you to get.
Kuna mahali Mungu anataka ukafika.
Where the light of God,
mahali ambapo mwanga wa kiungu,
is not just limited.
Haujasukumiwa tu.
It's just not limited.
Haujafungiwa.
To just what is written in the Bible.
Kwa yale tu yaliyoandikwa katika neno.
The Bible tells me.
Maandiko yananiambia.
That if Jesus did so many more things that were not written in the Bible.
Yesu alifanya mambo mengi zaidi ambayo haya.
That everything was written.
Kama yote yangeandikwa.
Everything was written.
Kama yote yangeandikwa.
The earth could not contain the books that would have been written upon it. Hata
dunia haingekuwa na imetosheleza vitabu vilivyoandikwa ndani.
Religious people box in God.
Watu wa kiungu humweki mfungia Mungu, mwekea mipaka.
Religion is an evil spirit.
Dini ni roho mbaya.
I said religion.
Dini
is an evil spirit.
Ni roho mbaya.
And religion,
na dini,
is man-made.
Imetengenezwa na mwanadamu.
Which religion did Christ come to promote?
Kwani dini gani ndio Yesu alikuja kuifuata?
Which religion did he say we should follow?
Ni dini gani alisema tukaifuata?
Is there a religion?
Kuna dini kweli?
What did he come for?
Alikuja
kwa. Did he die for religion?
Alikufa
kwa. What did he die for?
Alikufa kwa sababu ya nini?
Relationship, say relationship.
Uhusiano, sema uhusiano.
Relationship,
sema uhusiano.
Relationship,
uhusiano.
If you have a relationship with me,
kama una uhusiano na mimi,
then I can trust you with my stuff.
Basi naweza kuaminia vitu vyako.
If you don't have a relationship with me,
kama hauna uhusiano na mimi,
then forget it. I don't give you my stuff.
Basi sahau, siwezi kukupa vitu vyangu.
This person right here,
mtu huyu hapa.
This person right here,
mtu huyu hapa.
He's a soul.
Amejiuza wote.
He says none of me.
Amesema hakuna ndani yangu.
None of me.
Hakuna chembe changu.
But all of you Lord.
Lakini yote kwako
Bwana. All of you Lord.
Yote kwako Bwana.
All of you Lord.
Yote kwako Bwana.
All of you Lord.
Yote kwako Bwana.
All of you Lord.
Yote yako Bwana.
And he overflows.
Na anaweza.
And he overflows.
Anasikana.
Because there's no limit to God.
Kwa sababu Mungu
ni mkuu. And so God keeps pouring.
Mungu anaendelea.
And pouring.
Na kuweka.
It is a river. And it reaches to many. And it touches others. And it touches others. And it touches many. Rivers of living waters. That flow. Because there is no one to the Father. There is no one to the Father. There is no one to the Father. There is no end to the Father. There is no end to the Father. There is no end to the Father. This is what the Father is longing for.
Hivi ndivyo baba anatamani.
This is what he is initial.
Hii ilikuwa mpango.
He in his initial plan.
Mpango wake wa kwanza.
When he enjoyed fellowship with Adam.
Wakati alifurahia ushirika na Adamu.
Adam was none.
Adam
he just had the fullness of God.
Hapo na chochote alikuwa tuna utimilifu wa kiungu.
Until he listened to the wrong voice.
Mpaka wakati aliposikiza kwa sauti ambayo haikufaa.
That told him he was naked.
Ambayo ilimwambia hana nguo.
That told him, did he really say?
Ambayo ilimuuliza alisema kweli.
Made him doubt his identity.
Ilimfanya akaweza kushuku. Wakati unajishuku sehemu yako ndani ya Mungu.
Then you buy the lies from the kingdom of darkness.
Unanunua maisha ya ufalme wa giza.
The lies from the kingdom of darkness.
uongo kwenye ufalme wa giza.
And then you realize I am naked.
Alafu natambua niko uchi.
And the Father came.
Na Mungu akakuja.
In the fellowship.
Katika ushirika.
In the beauty.
Katika urembo.
In the nice.
Katika urembo.
Praise the name. Why did he come?
Kwa nini alikuja?
Why did he come?
Kwa nini alikuja?
Because of religion.
Kwa sababu ya dini.
He came because of religion.
Alikuja kwa sababu ya dini.
He came to visit Adam because of religion.
Alikuja kumstembelea Adam kwa sababu ya dini.
What did he have with Adam?
Alikuwa na nini na Adam?
Relationship.
Uhusiano.
He looked.
Na angalia.
And he searched.
Na akatafuta.
And he looked.
Na angalia.
And he said, "Where are you?"
Akasema uko wapi?
You think he was searching for his location?
Unafikiri alikuwa anatafuta sehemu yake?
Do you think God did not know where Adam was hiding?
Unafikiri Mungu hakujua sehemu Adam alipojificha?
What was God asking when he asked him, "Where are you?"
Mungu alikuwa anauliza nini alipomuuliza uko wapi?
He was asking him.
Alikuwa anamuuliza.
You are sitting on the throne.
Ulikuwa umeketi kwenye enzi.
In the heavenly places.
Katika mahali pa kiungu.
Your position.
Sehemu ya.
Was a position of dominion.
Ilikuwa ni sehemu ya utawala.
You are the boss.
Wewe ndio ulikuwa.
You are the one who says.
Wewe ndio ulikuwa ukisema.
What have you done?
Sasa umefanyaje?
What have you done?
Wewe umefanyaje?
Why have you left?
Kwa nini umewacha?
Your position.
Sehemu yako.
Who have you given your authority to?
Nani umepatia mamlaka yako?
Who told you?
Nani alikwambia?
You are naked.
Wewe uko uchi.
Which voice are you listening to?
Unasikiza sauti gani?
Which voice are you listening to?
Unasikiza sauti gani?
Today God is asking you.
Leo Mungu anakuuliza.
Who told you you're sick?
Nani alikwambia wewe ni mgonjwa?
Who told you you're barren?
Nani alikwambia wewe ni tasa?
Who told you you're poor?
Nani alikwambia wewe ni maskini?
Who told you you can't make it?
Nani alikwambia huwezi kufanya?
Which voice are you listening to?
Sauti ya nani unayosikiza?
Didn't I give you dominion?
Mimi nikupatia utawala.
Didn't I give you authority?
Kwani sikukupatia mamlaka?
Didn't I tell you and give you the power to become a child of God?
Kwani sikukwambia nitakupatia nguvu za kuwa mwana wa Mungu?
Didn't I get you back to the position of being a child of God?
Kwani sikukurejesha sehemu ya kuwa mwana wa Mungu?
Now who are you listening to?
Wewe unasikiza nani?
This place.
Mahali hapa.
Is where the Father dwells.
Ni mahali Baba anakaa.
It is the secret place of the Most High God.
Ni mahali pa siri pa Mungu aliye juu.
It is the Psalms 91 place.
Hapa ni mahali pa Zaburi 91.
Let me tell you.
Acha nikwambie.
Can you read for me Psalms 91?
Nisomee Zaburi 91.
You know?
Unajua?
People,
watu.
If only you know who you are.
Kama ungejua wewe nani.
If only you knew who you are.
Kama ungejua wewe ni nani.
If only you knew your dominion.
Kama ungejua utawala wako.
And stop running to every Tom, Dick and Harry looking for an anointing.
Ukimbilia kila mwanadamu kitafuta upako.
Because the anointing.
Kwa sababu upako.
Is in how empty.
Iko katika
uki. Can you be?
Ambao unao.
For God to fill you.
Wa Mungu kukujaza.
I told you God is not fair.
Nilikwambia Mungu asawazishi.
God will take somebody from the village of Kenoa like he did me.
Mungu atatoa mtu kwenye kijiji cha Kenoa kama alivyonifanyia.
And find this person empty.
Na afanye huyo mtu akuje mtu akiwa tupu.
And fill the vessel with himself.
Na ajaze chombo hicho na yeye mwenyewe.
God doesn't care where you are.
Mungu hajali uko wapi.
You can be in prison.
Unaweza kuwa umefungwa.
You may be watching me from the prison.
Unaweza kuwa unaniona kutoka kwenye.
How empty can you be?
Bora tuko utupu.
How empty can you be?
Una utupu wa hali gani?
Because God is willing to fill you with himself.
Sababu Mungu ako tayari kukujaza.
God is willing to fill you with himself.
Ako tayari kukujaza na yeye mwenyewe.
God is willing to fill you with himself.
Ako tayari kukujaza na yeye mwenyewe.
Kunywa maji.
Drink the water.
Thank you very much, brother. You know, the people who dwell in the Holy of Holies,
wale watu wanaoketi katika mahali patakatifu patakatifu,
in the inner place,
mahali pa ndani,
empty vessel,
chombo tupu,
may you be filled,
ujazwe.
Siniliombe mkije mkopolitie mkakata
utonde tukama ndio tukama.
The people who dwell in the Holy of Holies,
wale watu ambao wanaishi katika mahali pa ndani kabisa patakatifu patakatifu,
the light
Mwanga.
In the Holy of Holies.
Ndani ya patakatifu watakatifu.
Is the glory.
Ni utukufu.
Of God the Father himself.
Wa Mungu Baba mwenyewe.
He fills you with himself.
Anakujazanga na yeye mwenyewe.
That people look at you.
Hadi watu wanakuangalia.
And there is not just lamp. It's not a lamp. It's not just a lamp that you have to carry to light. Oh, let me see. What does this say? What does it say?
Sio katatu na kubeba kila sababu zake. Inasema nini? Inasema nini?
It is not limited to a place.
Haijafungiwa mahali.
You know, if you have a lamp.
Wakati una taa.
You have to carry it with you.
Lazima uibebe kila mahali unaenda.
So you can light certain corners.
Ili uweze kuwasha.
So you can light certain corners.
Uwashe sehemu tofauti.
But when you have the glory of God.
Lakini unapopata utukufu wa
Mungu. Your life is always lit.
Taa yako inakuanga wakati wote iko
sawa. The Bible says.
Maandiko yanasema.
That there is no shadow.
Ya kwamba hakuna.
There is no shadow.
Hakuna.
There is no shadow.
Hakuna kifuli.
There is no shadow.
Hakuna kifuli.
Everybody look on this side.
Angalieni pande.
Do you see my shadow?
Unaona kivuli changu?
You see my shadow?
Unaona kivuli changu?
Why?
Kwa nini?
Why?
Kwa nini?
There is light, right?
Dio.
There is light, right?
Sababu mwanga.
But it is limited light.
Lakini mwanga uliofungiwa.
There is limited light. That is why there is shadow.
Kuna mwanga chache ndio maana kuna.
The minute you get into the third dimension of God.
Wakati unafika katika sehemu ya tatu ya kiungu.
And his glory shines in your life.
Na utukufu wake unaangaza.
There is no shadow because he cannot find a place.
Hakuna kivuli kwa sababu kiwezi kupata
mahali. There is no darkness ever in your life.
Hakuna giza wakati wewe katika maisha yako.
The devil is afraid of you.
Unajua shetani anakuogopa.
That is why when they saw Jesus coming.
Ndio maana walipoona Yesu akija.
They did not wait for Jesus to say anything.
Hawakungoja Yesu aseme chochote.
They just saw the glory light.
Waliona utukufu ule
ukiwa.
Na wakasema hey.
Oh,
hey.
Jesus.
Yesu.
You son of God.
Mwana wa Mungu.
You are the glory light of God.
Wewe una utukufu wa Mungu.
Why are you here?
Kwa nini uko hapa?
Please have mercy on us.
Tafadhali ukuwa na mbona hapa na utuhurumie.
You will not need to speak to demons.
Hautapata neno na mapepo.
They will be running.
Watakuwa kidoka.
Because the glory of God.
Kwa sababu utukufu wa Mungu.
Is your light.
Ni mwanga wako.
The glory of God.
Utukufu wa Mungu.
Is your light.
Ni mwanga wako.
The glory of God.
Utukufu wa Mungu.
Is your light.
Ni mwanga wako.
The glory of God.
Utukufu wa Mungu.
Is your power.
Ni nguvu yako.
The glory of God.
Utukufu wa Mungu.
Is your revelation.
Ni ufunuo wako.
It is a rhema word of God.
Ni neno la wakati la Mungu.
You don't have to wait for anybody to give you prophecy.
Sio lazima mtu aweze kupatia. No.
You don't need prophecy.
Au itatu nabii.
The prophecy that comes.
Unabii unaokuja.
Comes to verify.
Unakuja kuhakikisha.
Prophecy is only supposed to say yes, it is true.
Unabii unastahili tu kusema ndio ni kweli.
If you are hearing it for the first time.
Kama unausikia kwa mara ya kwanza.
You have lost network.
Basi wewe umetupa network.
You should be the first one to hear it from the Father.
Unastahili kuwa mtu wa kwanza kusikia kutoka kwa Baba.
And when I come and tell you what the Father has said.
Basi ninapokuja nakwambia vile Baba amesema.
We are just supposed to do this.
Unastahili kusema unastahili tu kupatia high five.
Because you have it and I have it.
Kwa sababu umeisikia.
You got it and I got it.
Uipata na mimi nikaipata.
You're not here to say, oh, really you have.
Unastahili kusema, oh, kweli, kweli.
That is why.
You
are being deceived by false prophets.
Kwa manabii wa uongo.
Why don't you dwell in the secret place of the Most High?
Nini usiketi katika mahali patakatifu pa Mungu?
You know, this man, wonderful, handsome man sitting on this side.
Unajua mtu ambaye ameketi hapa huyu mtakashati.
This is my dad.
Huyu ni baba yangu.
Hi daddy.
Bali baba.
I love you. He's sitting with my grandma. Hi, Shosho. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The minute I walk into my father's house.
Dakika naingia katika nyumba ya baba yangu.
As soon as I say hi to my father.
Nikimwambia tu baba yangu habari.
Guess what he says?
Bila nasema.
Where is Lilian?
Wapi Lilian?
Lilian, did you come?
Lilian anakuja kwa.
Hi Lilian.
Habari Lilian.
She's my sister, she helps at home.
Yeye ni dada yetu.
My father says Lilian.
Baba yangu sema Lilian.
Pia yeye.
Patia yeye.
Pia yeye nyama.
Give her meat.
My dad knows I love to eat meat.
Baba anajua napenda nyama.
He says kila kitu.
Everything.
Give her anything she wants.
Patie kila kitu anataka.
I didn't even ask.
Hata hakuuliza.
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 But he says.
Lakini
he commands.
Yeye huwa.
He says.
Yeye husema.
Give my child.
Patie mtoto.
Whatever she wants.
Chochote anataka.
Give it to her.
Patie.
Whatever she wants.
Chochote anataka.
Give it to her.
Patie.
When I was coming to from the US.
Wakati nilikuwa nakuja kutoka Marekani.
I told mommy.
Mbia mama.
I told my mom.
Kaambia mama yangu.
I said mom.
Mama.
We have everything here in America.
Tuko na kila kitu hapa Marekani.
The only thing I don't have.
Kile kitu sina.
Is sausage.
Ni sausage.
And I am coming to eat sausages.
Na mimi nakuja huko kula sausage.
Every morning.
Kila asubuhi.
And every morning.
Na kila asubuhi.
I want 10 sausages for myself.
Nataka sausage 10.
Don't give me bread we have in America.
Patie mkate tuko
na. Don't give me pancake we have in America. Don't give me cake we have in America.
Patie cake.
I just want sausage.
Nataka tu sausage.
So that I eat when I go to America.
Yo, skip in America, skip to sawa.
Ready for the next one.
Sasa niko tayari hiyo ingine.
And when we were on the phone,
katiko kwa simu,
she said,
akasema,
Daddy, did you hear that?
Daddy, umesikia hiyo?
That your daughter
sana wako
is asking for sausages.
Anaitisha sausages.
And not just one or two.
Na si moja.
Just 10. She wants 10.
10.
Every day by herself.
Kila siku peke yake.
You know what he said?
Unajua alisema nini?
Pay her, yeye.
Give her.
Yote.
Kila kitu.
Pay her, yeye.
Everything, give her.
Give her.
Give her.
She said, you're going to buy all this?
Akamuliza utanunua hizo?
He said, yes.
Akasema ndio.
Everything.
Kila kitu.
That is my daddy.
Huyo ndiye baba yangu.
How can you believe it?
Na wewe uamini?
If my earthly father.
Kama baba yangu.
Can do that to me.
Anaweza kufanya hivyo.
How much more?
Na zaidi.
With my heavenly father.
Mungu wa mbinguni.
Give me.
Atanipatia.
When I dwell in the secret place.
Wakati nakaa katika mahali pake pa siri.
When I stay in his house.
Wakati naishi katika nyumba yake. Inasema he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High God shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Hey!
Hey!
What does it say? Everybody repeat it.
Inasema nini? Kila mtu rudia.
He that dwells in the secret place of the Lord shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Does it say he that visiteth?
Inasema aliyetembelea.
Once in a while you go and come out.
Mara moja moja unaenda alafu unatoka.
Remember.
Kumbuka.
We were told.
Tuliambiwa.
If God doesn't know your voice.
Kama Mungu hajui sauti
yako. My grandma died yesterday she said.
Unajua hapa nyangu alisema.
Talk to God.
Nena na Mungu.
Every day.
Kila siku.
Do not stop talking to God.
Usiache kunena na Mungu.
Because.
Kwa sababu.
When you are in need.
Wakati
utakapo. He already knows your voice.
Tayari anajua sauti yako.
But when you run to him.
Lakini ukimbia.
Only when you are in need.
Wakati unahitaji.
He will wonder who is that talking.
Atakuuliza nani huyo.
Who even know you?
Nakujua kweli.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High.
Yule anaishi katika pahali pa siri pa aliye juu.
Shall abide under the shadow.
Ataketi katika kivuli.
Of the Almighty. Who can access the shadow of the Almighty?
Nani anaweza kupenyeza kwenye kivuli wa Mwenyezi?
Can the devil?
Shetani.
Can Lucifer?
Shetani.
Can sicknesses?
Ugonjwa.
Can diseases?
Magonjwa.
Can poverty?
Umaskini.
The secret place of the Most High God.
Mahali pa siri pa Mungu aliye juu.
Now why are you worried?
Kwa nini wewe unafuna
mshtuka? Why are you praying so hard?
Kwa nini unaomba sana?
Why are you praying for protection?
Kwa nini unaomba Mungu akulinde?
Why it is a fact.
Na pale
ni it is a promise.
Ya kwamba ni ahadi.
You know when you promise something.
Unapoahidi kitu.
I don't need to come and beg you.
Sihitaji kuja kukuomba.
I just come and get it.
Ninakuja na kichukua.
I tell Uche, my husband and I we have an agreement with our three sons.
Unajua wangu na mimi huwa tuna makubaliano na vijana wetu watatu.
If you get straight A's all year long.
Ukipata A mwaka mzima.
You can ask for anything.
Itisha chochote.
Within reasonable limits.
Kupitia kwa wekiwa katika kiwango kinachokubalika.
You will get it.
Utakipata.
I don't care how much it is.
Sijali ni pesa ngapi.
I will give it to you.
nitakupatia.
My sons,
vijana wangu,
when they get
wanapopata
all straight A's,
timilifu,
all they have to do,
kile ambacho wanafanya,
is bring their report card,
ni kuleta tu ile ripoti.
There you go.
Mendo hiyo.
And you know what I do?
Unajua mimi nafanya nini?
I say, okay, what do you want?
Nasema unataka nini?
This is what I want. 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 This is what I want.
Nataka nini?
I said, done.
Nasema ndio hivyo.
Anything else? I actually asked them anything else?
Nauliza kuna kitu kingine?
Because it is a promise.
Kwa sababu ni ahadi.
And I have to keep my promise.
Lazima niweke ahadi yangu.
I am an earthly person.
Mimi ni wa duniani.
When God promises you something,
wakati Mungu anakuahidi,
the Bible says,
maandiko yanasema,
that the promises of God in Christ are yes and amen.
Ya kwamba ahadi za Mungu katika Kristo ni ndio na amina.
So I never ever ever ever.
Kwa hivyo sita why
I never beg God for what he has promised me.
Namuomba Mungu kile ambacho ameniahidi.
I remind him.
Ninamkumbusha.
I said, Father, you said.
Namwambia Baba ulisema.
And he says, yes, I said it. And it is done.
Ndio nimesema.
So today I want to tell you.
Kwa hivyo leo ningependa kuambia.
When you say God protect me.
Unaposema Mungu nilinde.
Oh, please protect me.
Oh, Mungu nilinde.
You must be not dwelling in a secret place of the Most High.
Lazima uwe kwamba hauishi katika mahali.
Because you are already supposed to be ensured of the protection.
Kwa sababu unastahili kuwa umeahidiwa
ule. And not just the protection.
Na sio ukulindwa tu.
Keep going and see.
Endelea utuone. He says, I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him I will trust.
He is my refuge.
Yeye kimbilio langu.
He is my fortress.
Ngome yangu.
My God,
Mungu wangu.
My trust is in him only.
Nitakayemwamini.
Continue.
Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence.
He shall do what?
Atafanya nini?
Deliverance is mine.
Ukombozi ni wangu.
It is guaranteed.
Imeweza kuhakikishiwa. Mtego wa mwindaji.
The witches cannot catch you.
Wachawi hawawezi kukushika.
They cannot bewitch you.
Hawawezi kukuroga.
Because just like he delivered the children of Israel from the curses that Balaam was trying to cast away.
Kama vile alivyokomboa wana wa Israeli kutoka kwa laana ambazo Balaki alijaribu kuwapa.
When the witches cast to curse you.
Wakati wachawi watajaribu kukulaani.
They bless you instead.
Watakubariki badala yake.
So witches and witch doctors work overtime to bless me.
Kwa hivyo watoa wachawi na waroki wanafanya kazi zaidi kunibariki.
Because when they go to say something, God turns it around into a blessing.
Wanapoenda kusema kitu Mungu ibadilisha inakuwa baraka.
When they say she is down.
Wakati wanaona niko.
When they say she is down.
Wakati wanasema niko chini.
The mouth, the words turn around as they're coming out of their mouth. They say she is exalted.
Maneno yao yanabadilishwa kutoka kwa maneno ya kwa mdomo wao wanasema ameinuliwa.
Until the person says ai.
Paka wakati mtu huyo anasema
ai. What are you saying?
Wewe unasema nini?
See, you are supposed to cast her.
Ulikuwa umulani.
But he will go and say.
Lakini laana anasema.
You cannot curse.
Always
him whom God has blessed.
You say about Bwana amebariki.
He that dwelleth in the secret place.
Yeye anaishi katika mahali pa siri.
Will never be cursed.
Hatawahi kulaniwa.
Let's go.
He says he shall cover thee with his feathers and under his wings shall thou trust. His thrust shall be thy shield and buckler.
Do you get it?
Unashika.
Do you get it?
Unashika.
Kwa mabawa yake atakufunika.
By his feathers he'll cover thee.
Nobody
hakuna
can see you
anayekuona.
When they look at you
wanapokuangalia,
see the Father,
wanaona Baba.
Because you are hidden,
kwa sababu umefichwa.
Because the glory of God is the one that is hiding you.
Utukufu wa Mungu ndio umekuficha.
Tuendelee.
Thou shall not be afraid for the terror by night nor for the arrow that flies by day.
Did you know that there are arrows that are being targeted at you during the day?
Unajua kuna mishale inayokutafuta mchana.
You do not see things in the spirit realm.
Kama huonangi mambo katika ulimwengu wa kiroho vizuri,
you need to the Holy Spirit.
Unahitaji Roho Mtakatifu.
The word of God says there are arrows during the day.
Neno la Mungu linasema kuna mishale katika siku.
That strike people during the day.
Ambayo inagonganga watu mchana.
And there's some at night that gets you at night.
Na kuna zingine zinakutafuta usiku.
During the day, at night, and there is evening, continue.
Na kuna mchana na usiku na kuna zingine katikati ya siku. Nor the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor the destruction that wasted at midday.
Do not be ignorant.
Usiwezi.
The devil does not sleep.
Shetani halali.
He works during the day.
Fanya kazi mchana.
Lunch time.
Fanya kazi.
And evening.
Fanya usiku.
And at night.
Na hata usiku.
But if you dwell in the secret place of the Most High,
kama unaketi katika
pa pa sita, how hard you work,
haijalishi uko wapi,
he will never get to you.
Hautafikiwa na adui.
Continue.
Endelea inasema, a thousand shall fall at the sides and 10,000 at the right hand, but he shall not come near you.
Keep going.
Sema, only with thy eyes shall you behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High God, thy habitation.
If you make the Most High your dwelling place,
ukimfanya aliye juu mahali pako pa kukaa,
when people are being killed left, right and center,
wakati watu wanauawa kando na kando,
you will only be seeing with your eyes.
Wewe utaona tu na macho yako.
The Bible says in Job,
maandiko yanasema
katika Yobu, that even the wicked will be delivered because of you.
Ya kwamba hata wale waovu watakombolewa kwa sababu
yako. But if you are one with God,
ama wewe uko pamoja vyema na Mungu,
you can say, Father, forgive them.
Utasema baba wasamehe.
And they will be forgiven.
Na watasamehewa.
But you do not have to walk in fear.
Lakini utatembea katika
hofu. A lot of us walk in fear because we do not know who we are.
Wengi wetu tunatembea kwa uoga kwa sababu hatujui.
And because we are not dwellers of the secret place of the Most High God.
Hatuketi katika mahali na papa mtakatifu pa yule mkuu.
Continue.
Yes. That is verse. Kama yasu. Verses 10 now. There shall not be evil befall thee. There shall no evil befall thee. Neither shall any plague come near thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels to charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. They shall bear thee up in their hands, lest thou dash thy foot against a stone. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, and the young lion and the dragon, and thou shalt trample them under thy feet. Because you have set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high, because he has known my name. He shall come upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
What more do you want?
Sasa nini zaidi unataka?
Is there anything in there that you do not want?
Kuna kitu hapo ndani yenye hutaki?
Isn't that a full package guaranteed?
Si hicho ni kifurishi kikubwa umehakikishiwa?
For the dwellers of the secret place of the Most High God.
Wale ambao wamefanya makao
yao. For the dwellers of the secret place of the Most High God.
Wamefanya makao yao mahali pasipo pa
Mungu. I dare you to dwell.
Ninawauliza tu tafadhali.
And your prayers will be prayers for the kingdom.
Na maombi yenu yatakuwa maombi ya ufalme.
Not simple prayers.
Maombi
like, oh God, protect me.
Oh Mungu nilinde.
Una protectiwa umeenda wapi?
Unalinda umeenda wapi?
Where have you gone for God to look for you to protect you?
Umeenda wapi ndio Mungu akutafuta kulinde?
There is guaranteed protection.
Kuna hakikisho la kulindwa.
In the presence of the Most High God.
Wa Mungu aliye juu.
Today women.
Leo wadada.
I want to tell you.
Napenda kuambia.
I started by asking you who you are.
Nilianza kwa kuuliza nyinyi ni nani.
And I want to finish.
Nataka kumaliza.
Telling you.
Kuambia
who you are.
Nyinyi ni nani.
Who you are.
Nyinyi ni nani.
Who you are.
Nyinyi ni nani.
It started.
Ilianza.
When I got tired of church as usual.
Wakati nilikasirika kwenda kanisa kama kawaida.
Because I went to church.
Sawa nilienda kanisa.
Every single Sunday.
Kila Jumapili.
Midweek service.
Ibada za katikati.
I was a praise and worship leader.
Nilikuwa kiongozi wa sifa na ibada.
Nothing.
Hakuna
change in my life.
Kitu kilichobadilika.
I was a struggler.
Nilikuwa natembea.
I did not know what God was saying.
Sikuwa najua Mungu anasema nini.
I did not know what he wanted.
Sikujua vile
anataka. I was just living with a name.
Nilikuwa naishi tu na jina.
Christian. That name did not change me.
Jina hilo halikunibadilisha.
It never changed me.
Halikunibadilisha.
Until one day.
Hadi siku moja.
I went on my knees.
Nikaenda kwa magoti.
And I said.
Na nikasema.
Father.
Baba.
In the name of Jesus. I am tired. For this church as usual. There must be more to you than this.
Can
I said you promised me. The Holy Spirit. Where is he? I need him now. Holy Spirit. You were there. When I was being created. Where God said. Let us make man in our own image. You were there. And you saw me being created. And you saw what was put in me during creation. Now you reveal it to me. And help me fulfill it. Like you did Christ. In Jesus' name. And Father.
Na Baba.
I want to see my Savior. And don't send me any angels. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
And I went about my business. One week later. My producer, the one who produced my first CD, was having a birthday party at his house. And it had rained cats and dogs. And you know what happened? My husband had traveled. And I had my three sons. And my brother's son. And I could not even hardly see as I was driving. I wanted to go back home and say, there's no point of going to this. But I just felt, let go.
Let's go.
And I said, I'm going to go. At the birthday party, there was a prophet. And he was not planning to minister. We were just cutting cake and having fun. All of a sudden, he started feeling sweaty and he removed his ring because he says when he feels the spirit coming upon him, his ring will get stuck on his finger. So he usually takes it out so that he can be able to
open it.
He came to where I was. And he said, you have asked to know God in a very intimate way. And he'll reveal himself to you. And then he said, and God says that you're an author of many books. I looked around to see, did
anyone
even somebody else standing behind me? Because I don't like to write. I wrote a lot of compositions when I was young.
And
like I told some people, my mom was an English teacher. And we wrote compositions every night at home. And sometimes we would go to Shosho and Uncle John. You would make us write compositions. So many compositions I didn't like.
Well, spender.
I got it. I said, okay. And then he said, you're like a balloon. God is going to disconnect you from many people who are holding you down.
Kutokana na watu wengi
ambao because he wants you to rise so high for his glory. Immediately.
Papo hapo.
I said, hallelujah.
Nikasema hallelujah.
The prophecy was done. Remember I asked to know God in an intimate way? That was a confirmation. You do this. That was a confirmation.
That is the one you give high five.
When I went home, I just felt that I needed to pray. I went to the basement. We used to live in Georgia. And in Georgia, we have basements because of tornadoes. When you have a tornado, it can take your whole house.
Unajua huko Georgia tunaishi tuko na basements kwa sababu ya vipunga.
So when the house is taken, at least you remained under there under.
Ndio nyumba ikibebwa unakaa huko chini kwa chumba hicho cha chini.
So my basement was the place where I would go to pray.
Kwa hivyo chumba hicho ndio nilikuwa naenda kuomba.
And I went to pray.
Na nikaenda kuomba.
And I knelt down to pray.
Na nikapiga magoti kuomba.
And me, I didn't know how to pray.
Na mimi sikujua jinsi ya kuomba.
Because I saw people, I thought people stayed for long.
Na nilifikiria watu wanakaa kwa maombi sana.
So yes, I knelt down.
Ndio nikapiga magoti.
And I
I just prayed the normal prayer.
Nikaomba maombi ya kawaida.
And I said amen.
Nasema amen.
And I went to get up.
Nikaenda kusimama.
And the Holy Spirit spoke.
Na Roho Mtakatifu akanena.
That was the first time I had the Holy Spirit speaking.
Ilikuwa mara ya kwanza niliwahi sikia Roho Mtakatifu akinena.
He said wait a minute.
Nikasema ngoja tu.
Where are you going?
Unaenda wapi?
I said, huh?
Nikasema eh.
He said prayer is a dialogue, not a monologue.
Akasema maombi si kuongea peke yako, ni maongezi ya watu wawili.
Now you have spoken.
Sasa umeongea.
Why don't you wait for the Father to speak?
Tuacha na Baba aongee.
Yeah.
Haya.
I said, oh.
Akasema aha.
Lesson learned.
Nijifunza hivi.
I stayed like this.
Kakaa hivi.
I'm closing my eyes.
Nimefunga macho.
I'm just waiting.
Nimengoja.
I wait.
Kangoja.
I wait.
Kangoja.
I wait.
Kangoja.
All of a sudden.
Dafu.
With my eyes closed, the heavens opened, and Jesus himself came down.
Na Yesu mwenyewe akashuka.
He came down.
Akashuka.
My eyes are closed, but I can see him.
Macho yangu yamefungika lakini namuona.
And as he came down.
Akakuja.
And I could see this side of his face because he's coming facing me.
Na nilikuwa naona uso wake kwa sababu alikuwa anakuja ameniangalia.
So this side of the face I could see.
Kwa hiyo sehemu ya uso nilikuwa naiona.
And his eyes, so it was like halfway, but he's coming. One side is shaded, one side is so clear.
Na macho yake nilikuwa namuona na upande mmoja alikuwa imefunika, mmoja naona nimefunguka.
And as he came close to me.
Na aliponikaribia.
I saw his eye.
Nikaona macho yake.
His eye.
Jicho lake.
I have never even imagined.
Sijawahi hata kutafakari.
Of such an eye.
Jicho.
It was the busiest eye.
Ilikuwa jicho lio makinika ambalo nimewahi kuona.
In that one eye,
katika jicho
I saw the whole world.
Niliona dunia
with people doing things.
Watu wanafanya vitu.
This one was doing this. This one was doing this. This one was doing this.
Watu wanafanya vitu.
Me, I was overwhelmed. Oh my.
Mimi nilichanganyikiwa sana.
And then he turned around.
Alafu akapinduka.
And went back.
Na akarejea.
And I was overwhelmed.
Na mimi nikashangaa.
And I opened my eyes.
Nikafungua macho yangu.
And I said, oh my gosh.
Akasema kweli.
He came. You brought Jesus to me. The way I asked. Remember, I was very broken when I asked that. I told God, if you don't come to teach me yourself, I am lost. Because I am done with church. I am done with religion. If you don't come to teach me yourself, then forget me in the kingdom. Because I'm not listening to anybody else's teaching. Immediately, I went upstairs. My husband, you know, at that point in time, he would think I'm crazy. He would probably have taken me to a psych hospital. So I knew better not to tell my husband. I had a 7-year-old son, my older one. Now he's 19. He's a big guy. I went to him, I said, Trevor, I saw Jesus. Don't tell anybody. How can you contain? After you see your Lord Jesus. I even asked Jesus. I said, Yemi, you healed somebody. And then you tell them, don't tell them.
Mimi.
After I have seen you, I was ready to tell everybody. But I knew better. So the following day was Sunday. We are getting ready with my husband to go to church.
Yeah,
I was going to church because of my husband, not because of me. Because I was there, like I tell you, I was just going to church. When I was dressing up, I told my husband, by the way, yesterday when I went to pray, imagine, I saw Jesus. Then I knew that God speaks through people. Because that was not my husband speaking. That was the Holy Spirit and God himself saying, when you talk to me, I hear, and I answer. The first book was birthed from that.
He started revealing to me who I was. It's called your God-given task. What did God put in you during creation? Finding out your purpose. And knowing who you are. By the Holy Spirit of God. Would I have known my purpose if I didn't have the Holy Spirit? Would I have known? Would I have known? You will never know. Until you allow the Holy Spirit in your life. I want some people volunteers who can blow balloons. You never know, you will get the balloon to take. Guys, come on. People who can blow balloons. As I finish, we gotta finish this.
Napomaliza.
Take one balloon. Stand behind the table.
Simama nyuma ya meza.
My second book.
Kitabu changu cha pili.
My friend the Holy Spirit.
Rafiki yangu Roho Mtakatifu.
There is a chapter in this book.
Kuna mambo katika kitabu hiki.
That all I speak about.
Ambayo yote nayo yanena.
Is me and him, our conversation, our relationship, our love.
Na yeye maongeo yetu, upendo wetu.
And it is a daily thing.
Na ni jambo la kila siku.
Do you know my baby, my 12-year-old, Amani? The people who are here the last time is they saw him. He says, Mommy, how come you know everything we do? Even when you try to hide, you know it. Who is the snitch? I just laughed. The other day he came. After he read, they love reading my books. He came to the bed. And he says, Mom, I found out who the snitch is. It's the Holy Spirit. I said, you got it, dude.
The
snitch. Don't blow it yet. Remove the air a little bit. Just remove the air. You are created.
Uliumbwa.
You are created.
Uliumbwa.
As a balloon.
Kama balloon.
As a balloon.
Kama balloon.
As a balloon.
Kama balloon.
If this balloon is like that.
Ikiwa hivyo.
Is it moving?
Nasonga.
Is it moving?
I saw it.
Is it even beautiful?
Ata ina urembo wote.
Is it even useful?
Ata inaweza kutumiwa.
Without Jesus.
Bila Yesu.
Without God.
Bila Mungu.
As much as you are created in the fullness of who He is.
Hata kama uliumbwa katika utimilifu wa utele wake.
You have nothing.
Hauna.
You are nothing.
Wewe si chochote.
When you receive Christ in your life, you get the breath of God in you. Now,
sasa,
you are a little bit visible. Right?
Kiasi.
You are beginning to take shape. People are like,
oh
yeah, when you are different.
Kusema, hey, na
because everybody else is just like the before. You remember the before?
Vile ulikuwa hapo mbele.
Now people start saying, haya.
Watu wanaanza kusema, haya.
Yeah.
Haya.
Kwani there is more to it than just that thing.
Kumbe kuna kuanga na zaidi kuliko vile na kuanga.
Now you receive the Son.
Umepokea mwana.
You receive the Son Jesus.
Umepokea mwana ambaye ni Yesu Kristo.
You receive Jesus.
Umepokea Yesu Kristo.
You receive Jesus.
Umepokea Yesu Kristo.
Now you're starting to take shape.
Umeanza kuchukua kuchukumbika.
If I throw this balloon up.
Naporusha balloon hii juu.
What will happen to it?
Nitafanyika.
Will it go high?
I tie that true.
Why?
Kwanini?
Why?
Kwanini?
Why?
Kwanini?
It's not what? It's not full.
Haijaja.
It's not full.
Haijaja.
It's not even as beautiful as it's supposed to be.
Hata urembo wake.
Some of you have settled for this.
Tumeweza kukaa hapo.
This is where you are.
Hapa ndio uko.
This is where you are comfortable.
Hapo ndio umekatalia.
You have decided. As long as at least I know I have Jesus, I have Jesus. I'm good to go. There is that thing that God had created you. in the beauty and the fullness of who he is. Women, you are helpers. Women, there is an assignment. There is an assignment. There is an assignment. There is an assignment. That God has for you. There is an assignment that God has for you.
Kuna kazi ambayo Mungu amekupatia.
The minute you understand your assignment.
Dakika unapoelewa kazi yako.
The minute you accept the Holy Spirit of God in you.
Dakika unapoelewa Roho Mtakatifu ndani yako.
To help you understand.
Kukusaidia ukaelewa.
That you are created to be in the image.
Ya kwamba uliumbwa
and the likeness.
Katika umbo.
And the beauty.
Katika urembo.
With the mind of Christ.
Na mafikira za Kristo.
And other people can see God and want him.
Ya kwamba watu wengine wanaweza kuona Mungu na kumtizama.
Other people can see God and celebrate him.
Watu wanaweza kumuona Mungu na kumsherekea.
That other people,
watu wengine,
can be able to do this.
Wanaweza kufanya hivi.
And they can enjoy this God.
Wanaweza furahia huyu Mungu.
In you.
Ndani yako.
You are impacting many.
Wewe unagusa wengi.
You are touching.
Unagusa.
Keep it going to the back.
Wacha iende kule nyuma.
Touch to touch.
Touch
to touch.
Kugusa kuguswa.
Keep going.
Endelea.
Keep going.
Endelea.
Let everybody touch.
Ambia kila mtu gusa.
But they are all full. You don't have to be alike.
lazima ufanane.
You don't have to be light.
Sio lazima
upende. You don't have to be dark.
Sio lazima
upende. You don't have to be full of shame. You don't have to be full of fear.
Uwe na umbo.
No.
Hapana.
You are beautiful.
Wewe ni mrembo.
As long as you're full of God.
Kama uko na dark Mungu,
wewe ni mrembo. As long as you're full of the Holy Spirit.
Kama umejazwa na
Roho. You're beautiful.
Una urembo.
You're beautiful.
Una urembo.
You're beautiful.
Una urembo.
Your beauty is in fact God.
Your
beauty is in fact God.
Your
beauty is in fact God.
Urembo wako ndani ya Mungu.
Urembo mwingine wote wa puri. Urembo mwingine wote wa puri.
Urembo mwingine wote wa puri.
Kuna
watoto. Mamia
Jesus. Kuna watoto. Hallelujah. Give a hand
clap unto the Lord. Yesu makofi.
Now stand up onto your feet right now.
Simama kwa miguu yako sasa.
And if you're ready to be filled today.
Na kama uko tayari kujazwa leo.
If you're tired of just being one that sits there and
kama umechoka kwa yule ambaye anasimama tu.
Nobody can see you. Nobody can see God in you. Nobody can receive God. You cannot touch somebody. Because you are not touched yourself. Because you are full. You think you are full. But you are empty. Everybody is trying to look for a full vessel. But God is looking for an empty vessel. Everybody is looking for a full vessel. God is looking for an empty vessel. Let me tell you. Do you think I came up with balloons?
Unafikiria nikuja na balloons?
You think I came up with balloons?
Unajua mimi unafikiria mimi ndio nilitengeneza balloons?
No, do you think I came up with this sermon about balloons?
Unafikiria mimi nilikuja na sermon hiyo na ujumbe huo wa balloon?
Do you know?
Unajua?
When I was still in the United States.
Wakati nilikuwa kule Marekani.
And I was asleep. And I dreamt.
Kaota.
And I dreamt this whole sermon.
Nikaota ujumbe wote.
I was in the stadium and I was preaching to a great crowd of people.
Kwa kwenye mkutano mkubwa na nilikuwa nahubiria watu wengi.
And I was preaching.
Nilikuwa nahubiri.
And this was the sermon that I was preaching.
Na ujumbe huu ndio nilikuwa nikihubiri.
When I woke up.
Wakati niliamka.
This is 6/12/19. 6 ni nini ni June 12th, 2019.
Ilikuwa mwezi wa 6/2019 tarehe 12.
Someone in a dream.
Ujumbe ndani ya ndoto.
I did not speak this.
Sikunena haya.
It is not my idea.
Sio fikra yangu.
It is God's idea.
Ni mafikra ya Mungu.
For those who were here yesterday.
Kwa wale waliokuwa hapa jana.
I told you.
Niliwaambia.
I do not know how to write songs.
Sijui jinsi ya kuandika nyimbo.
The Holy Spirit is a worshipper.
Roho Mtakatifu huabudu.
He's a praiser.
Yeye usifu.
He gives me songs in the night.
Yeye unipatia nyimbo usiku.
He gives me songs during the day.
Unipatia nyimbo mchana.
He gives me songs in worship.
Unipatia nyimbo za kuabudu.
In tribes and languages that I am not even fluent in.
Ananipatia katika lugha ambazo hata sizineni vizuri.
The other day he gave me a song in tongues and he interpreted it himself.
Alinipatia neno na akaweza kuitafsiri yeye mwenyewe.
He gave me this sermon to give you today in a dream.
Alinipatia ujumbe ili kuwapatieni nyinyi katika ndoto.
Yesterday the sermon he gave me, I was seated there.
Jana ujumbe alionipatia nilikuwa nimeketi
pale. I am not taking credit because I cannot.
Siwezi kuimiliki kwa sababu siwezi.
I am just an empty vessel.
Mimi ni chombo tupu.
And I let him fill me and overflow me.
Na mimi umwacha kanijaze.
As he wills.
Kama anavyotaka.
And the Father wants the same for you.
Na Baba anataka vile vile kwako.
He wants you to be empty.
Anataka uwe tupu.
That he can fill you with himself.
Hawezi kukujaza na yeye
mwenyewe.
Maisha na kuyabadilisha.
There's so many sermons you hear.
Kuna ujumbe nyingi ambazo wewe usikia.
And cannot change you at all.
Ambazo siwezi kubadilisha.
And I told him.
Na nikamwambia.
Don't send me anywhere.
Usinitume mahali.
If you don't put your love for the people in me.
Kama hautaweka upendo wako kwa watu kwangu.
And don't send me anywhere.
Na usinitume mahali.
Where you don't speak.
Mahali ambapo hautanena.
Because I don't know what to say.
Kwa sababu sijui niseme nini.
I don't wanna talk.
Nastaki kuongea.
I want you to talk.
Nataka wewe uongee.
He is a spirit.
Yeye ni roho.
And they that worship him.
Na wanaomwabudu.
Must worship him in spirit and in truth.
Sima wanaomwabudu kwa roho na kweli.
He wants to use you.
anataka kukutumia.
Spirits are illegal on earth.
Unajua maroho hayapewi ruhusa kutembea duniani.
There is no way.
Hakuna njia.
Jesus would have come to earth.
Yesu angekuja duniani.
Unless he was in a body.
Ila tu angekuwa na mwili.
And even now.
Na hata sasa.
There is no way.
Hakuna njia.
The Father.
Ambao Baba.
Can come to earth.
Anaweza kuja duniani.
Unless he is inside you.
Ila tu awe ndani yako.
But unfortunately.
Lakini tu.
Many of us.
Wengi wetu.
Are so full of our worries.
Tumejazwa na kushtuka kwetu.
Of our cares.
Na majani
yetu. Of our religion.
Na dini zetu.
Of all we want.
Ambao ambao tunajua.
That are useless.
Ambao ni bure.
That God cannot use us.
Ya kwamba Mungu hawezi kututumia.
That God cannot touch.
Ya kwamba Mungu hawezi kutugusa.
His own people.
Watu wake wenyewe.
He wants to heal.
Anataka kuponya.
But how can he heal?
Lakini anawezaje kuponya?
It is not inside of you.
Kama yuko ndani yako.
So you can touch somebody to be healed. Ya
kwamba ukagusa mtu aponywe.
He wants to deliver.
Anataka kukomboa.
But how can he deliver?
Lakini atakomboa.
If you are just full of yourself.
Kama wewe bado umejazwa na wewe mwenyewe.
He paid such a big price.
Alilipa gharama kubwa
so that you can have the dominion back.
Ya kwamba ukapokea umiliki ulio nao.
Be Jesus is on earth.
Yesu Kristo akiwa duniani.
Be Jesus on earth.
Na uwe Yesu Kristo duniani.
The Father is the one who thinks.
Baba ndiye ufikiri.
The Son is the one who speaks.
Mwana ndiye unena.
And the Holy Spirit is the one who manifests.
Na Roho Mtakatifu ndiye udhihirisha.
Today the Father has spoken.
Leo Baba amenena.
The Son has spoken.
Mwana amenena.
The Holy Spirit is ready to manifest.
Wako tayari kudhihirisha.
He said today.
Anasema leo.
He will feel.
Atajaza.
All those who are empty.
Wale wote waliotupu.
He will feel.
Atajaza.
All those who are willing.
Wale walio
to be filled by him.
Ambao wako tayari kujazwa
na yeye. Today you are ready.
Leo tayari.
Lift your hands up.
Inua mikono yako juu.
Lift your hands up.
Inua mikono yako juu.
If you are willing.
Kama uko tayari.
To accept.
Kuweza kukubali.
To be filled by the Father.
Kujazwa na Baba.
To take shape.
Kuchukua umbo.
To know who you are.
Kujua wewe ni nani?
In God.
Ndani ya Mungu.
To know who you are.
Kujua wewe ni nani?
In God.
Ndani ya Mungu.
Remember.
Kumbuka.
When the Holy Spirit will come.
Wakati Roho Mtakatifu anakuja.
He not only fills you with himself.
Hata fanya peke yake.
He fills you with who the Father is.
Anakujaza na moyo utele wa Baba.
And like just those hydrogen balloons.
Na kama zile balloons za hydrogen.
The ones that even have to have a fire to climb up for people to get into the little kikapu so that they can go up in the air.
Ambazo zinaikamwa moto na watu wanaingia kwa kikapu wanapanda juu hewani.
Those are what he wants. He wants to be that big balloon.
Anataka kuwa hiyo balloon kubwa.
With the fire of the Holy Spirit.
Na moto wa Roho Mtakatifu.
That lifts you up.
Na kuinua juu. Aenda juu. akaweza kukuweka utupu.
come here.
Joapa,
you get a quick hug from me.
Upoke.
He's going to fill you.
Atakujaza.
And you will never be the same again.
Na hautawahi kuwa
in Jesus.
Katika jina la
Yesu. In Jesus name.
Katika jina la
Yesu. In Jesus name.
Katika jina la
Yesu. In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Make sure you are in this line.
Uhakikishe kama uko kwa hii line.
You have emptied yourself.
Umejiweka.
You have said Father.
Umesema Baba.
By your spirit.
Kupitia kwa roho wako.
I empty myself.
Ninajiweka tupu.
Of everything that is not of you.
Wa kila kitu kisicho changu.
That you may fill me.
Ya kwamba ukanijaze.
That you may fill me.
Ukanijaze.
That you may fill me.
Ukanijaze.
I want to hear you.
Nataka kusikia.
Because from today.
Kwa sababu kuanzia leo.
From today.
Kuanzia leo.
From today.
Kuanzia leo.
Oh, nikaraba baba
sateke.
Nikaraba baba baba sateke.
Yeah, come on.